There was a young man. He's autistic and was accused of molesting a girl. But he didn't know what he was doing. So the parents came to see me. They were very worried. So I took up the case. The charges were dropped. The parents love him. Because he's autistic, he's very good in music. He plays the organ. When I visited him, he was so excited. He said, come, come. And he brought me to his bedroom. I took off my shoes, went to his bedroom, and he wanted me to hear what he has composed being played by him. After a few years, I met him just the other night at a Ker Thai. He said, Minister Yeo, come, come. I want to play again for you. I want to play on a Ker Thai, but they won't allow me. This is what we do as MPs in the grassroots. How can we just desert the people who've elected us, who have served, and just go next door and say, okay, I will use these people now for other objectives? I'm not going anywhere. I'm staying in Aljunied GRC. The issue for the people of Aljunied is not the Workers' Party, which has limited capabilities. And I think people know, and they know, that in terms of looking after the people here, we have a track record, we have carried our promises, we have plans, there is a trust in what we say. And they know when we talk about Aljunied 10, that we will carry out those plans. And by the next election, we'll be judged by those plans. However, many people do want the Workers' Party to remain in, do want Mr. Lau Tia Kiang to remain in Parliament. He knows this. And his strategy is to force a choice by coming here. And it's caused a lot of discomfort among many people. In Tapao this morning, there was a letter. And someone said, Xue Shu, 我们都是历史的罪人. The letter writer said, whoever wins, whoever loses, we are sinners in history. This is a dilemma which Lau Tia Kiang has deliberately created for the people of Aljunied. And he does this by exploiting the resentment of the people. And because of this, I'm not allowed to criticize the Workers' Party. I find it a little strange. One day my son came back from camp, he's in NS, and he said, Daddy, don't criticize the Workers' Party. I said, how can I not criticize the Workers' Party? They are my opponents. He said, if you criticize the Workers' Party, people will be angry with you. I pondered, what is the meaning of this? No, it is not the Workers' Party. The Workers' Party is merely being used as a loudspeaker for many Singaporeans who feel pain, who think that the government is high-handed and arrogant, and they want to speak up. And the Workers' Party is there, they're using it as the Workers' Party. That is the real reason. And that is why I say the real issue is not the Workers' Party, but how we address the feelings, the heartfelt feelings of many people in Singapore, which in this election have all come out, and which all of us in our own way have heard. as a result of this in Aljunied, the election campaign is being fought on two levels. At the local level, frankly, there's no contest. In terms of looking after you, your daily needs, your environment, safety, predictability, a good living environment, even the Workers' Party will concede that we'll do better. When Lau Chia Kiang was asked, he said, "Hougang is not a slum. Well, we have much higher standards than that." But there is another level at which the campaign is being fought. And that is this resentment against the government. And I want to tell the people of Aljunied this, that my teammates and I will be your voice in government. They know we will listen. Listen hard. And feed up and help shape policies in parliament, in government, and in the cabinet. But we must not make light of the feelings. The feelings are still there, and they are raw. Old people, married people, but especially young people. You know, when people are angry, sometimes they get very emotional. You lose your temper. We lose our temper. We say things, we do things which we regret later. But when we are angry and someone tries to reason with us, we reject it. So when MM said, "You will have to repent," this created greater anger, greater resentment in many people. Last night, when I was having my kuay chap supper at Block 401, opposite Punggol Park, I went around shaking hands. And one Chinese man in his 40s, he said, "I'm voting for the Workers' Party because of what MM Lee said." I looked at him with a certain sadness and I said, "I respect your feeling. We must recognize that there is widespread unhappiness about the government. It is not only about specific policies. It is more than that. And we must not allow the emotions to be all bottled up. Some of it is because of globalization and technology. There's so much change in the world. Many of us feel that the world is turning too fast. And we want the world to slow down because we can't catch up. You know, technology, iPhone, iPad, this, that. Sometimes you feel the older we are, the more obsolete we become. And this has created a lot of a sense of dislocation and stress. Older people who feel that, well, in the past, the older you are, the more you know, the more wisdom you have, the more you're respected. Many now feel lonely. They feel that their children are overseas, doing this and that, sometimes don't have time for them. And then when they face more pressure from the government, it all comes out. And Singaporeans work very hard. Long hours. When I go door-to-door visiting from 7 to 9 p.m., more than half of the households are empty. Young couples, they want housing. They want to get married and form a family. They have issues. I'm not saying that the government has necessarily done wrong. But we must exercise flexibility because no two cases are the same. And we are flesh and blood. We are not robots. We are not things. and we have to be treated as human beings. This is very important. And let me talk about the feelings of young people. And I see many of my young friends in the audience today. In the last few years, they have taught me many things. They've helped teach me how to blog, get onto Facebook, create a second Facebook account, how to communicate, how not to communicate, how to speak, how to listen. And I'm very grateful to them. And because of them, I'm running this campaign in a very different way from all my previous campaigns. But this is just the group who are helping me. There are other groups who I'm not in touch with who also feel the same way, all over Singapore and some outside Singapore. When I was at SMU, in a dialogue session, one girl asked me a question without emotion. She said, "We feel helpless." I said, "What do you mean?" She said, "We feel helpless. You decide on a casino, you build a casino." And she talked about other things. I explained to her that we spent a year debating the casino. But somehow, she did not feel engaged. And many people feel that way. 2 days ago, I was very busy. It was a long day. My young friend said, "Do a video recording and talk to them." So I went down to Queen Street, did a recording, used a teleprompter. It did not come out right because I was reading. And my eyes showed that I was reading. So the producer said, "Speak from your heart." And after a few takes, I said, "I've got to rush for a girl tie. This should be good enough." I looked at it, I said, "Oh, I look a bit tired. Never mind, just put it out." It went viral. To my shock, it went viral. I felt a little sad that it went viral. For it to go viral was, of course, very good for me politically. But I felt sad about it going viral because it was a simple message, 2 minutes. And many people felt moved. If they could be moved by such a short clip, it shows that they crave communication. And that they feel that somehow we are talking to them and not talking, we are talking at them and not talking to them. And unless we engage young people and allow them to teach us, I don't think we can communicate with them. And once there's communication, the influence becomes two-way. They've influenced me, and I think I've influenced those who have helped me too. And the result is, they are better, and I'm better. And this is what our country should be.